I know we love our high heels. I do, at least. I would love to be able to wear them all day long. And now, finally, a doctor here is telling me that I can. Dr. Liza is here.
Yes, absolutely.
Yay! You can wear them. So it's not so much that you can't wear them, it's about the shoe that you are wearing.
Exactly. So it's about choosing the right heel. I mean, over the years, I've seen so many patients who have come in with high heel related injuries. Mm-hmm. Anything from sprains, strains, to fractures. So I thought, you know what? Women shouldn't have to suffer because of high heels.
Amazing. So you are a chiropractor.
Yes.
You have your own business and you wear your heels all day.
Exactly. So I mean, I like to look good. I like to be stylish.
Yes.
And I like to wear heels because they have that effect. They make you look taller. They make you look slimmer, so
yes.
That's why I love wearing high heels, and I wanted a heel that I could wear all day, and also a heel that I could recommend to my patients so that they could still be stylish but also be comfortable and not risk injury.
There's certain things you've done with your heel that you should be looking for in all heels if you expect to be wearing them all day, and we're going to start with picking the perfect pitch.
Yeah, so when we talk about pitch, we're referring to the actual angle of the heel. So the higher the pitch or the overall height, the worse the shoe. So
this
is
an example of a high pitch.
Exactly.
Right?
So this pitch here is almost 5 inches, and you see the angle here.
Yeah.
So when you have that high of a pitch, there's
a
lot of pressure on the base of your toes.
Yeah.
But one of the ways that we can help reduce the pitch is with a platform.
Right.
Yes. So that is why in my shoe, I included a platform. So the heel itself is 3 3/4 inches.
Mm-hmm.
The platform is 3/4 inches. So then we look at the overall pitch, it's only 3 inches. And ideally, to maintain your overall alignment, you don't want to wear heels that have more than 3 inches of pitch.
Okay.
Yes.
That totally makes sense. And I've always found that a platform is a lot more comfortable.
Absolutely.
And it's because it's redistributing the pitch, right?
Yes.
Choose a particular kind of insole. What are we looking for when it comes to insoles?
Okay, so the golden rule when it comes to insoles is you want them to be leather.
Yes.
Your body does well with a natural material.
Okay.
You want to have
leather.
Yes, they're leather, and you want an arch support. So if your arches are well supported, again, you're not going to put too much pressure on the base of your toes.
Right.
And then the last thing you want is cushion, right? So when you're walking, you want every step to be nice and cushioned. So when you feel it, you want to feel a natural spring. So you can also see that these shoes have a nice cushion and an insole as well.
So you can sort of tell that when you buy the shoe. I mean, just feel up and down in the insole. This feels like a cloud.
Yes, and
that's
you want
really nice.
To be able to, you know, if you jump in them, you want to feel that your landing is nice and cushioned.
That's
so
right.
So the support, the cushion, and the leather.
I love
those are
this
three
life
things
that
you want in the insole.
In
yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So good. Okay, let's talk about the sole. It should be a rubber sole.
Okay. So with a sole, you'd want to prevent slipping. If you have a slippery sole, so like for example, if you have a sole like this that's slippery, when you are walking, the muscles in your foot have to work really hard in order to create that stability.
Yes.
There's strain on your ankles, there's strain on your knees. So
there's
what
nothing
you,
there.
No, so what you want is a nice rubber sole, because that provides some grip. So when you are walking, whether there's rain outside, whether there's snow, or just in regular material, your feet don't have to work extra hard because you have that nice rubber at the bottom
That's
there.
Right. It's a bit of a tread there.
Yes,
right?
Exactly.
Okay, so that's going to help as well. The thicker the heel, the happier the foot. So how are these on your scale?
Okay, so these are awesome, right? These are 2-inch chunky heel, which means that not only do you not have too much height or too much pitch, you also have a nice center of gravity.
Yeah.
You're not, you know, wobbling around on a stiletto like you would in something like this.
Right.
I mean, this heel is as thin as a pencil.
Lethal.
Yeah, so when you're doing this, it can put strain on the muscles because they have to work extra hard, but also it can cause laxity in your ligaments because your ankle is wobbling trying to stabilize it, your foot is wobbling.
I hear you.
Knee and hip and back pain injuries as well.
Now, there's a few little things that you can do to help if you have been wearing heels for a while.
Absolutely.
You've got 3 different moves that you can do.
Yes. So we mentioned instability.
Yes.
One of the things you can do to help counteract that is to strengthen your glute med muscles.
Okay.
So to do that, we are going to do some hip abduction.
Okay.
So that you just bring your leg out, and in.
Okay.
And out and in. So not only are you working the muscle that's bringing your leg up,
yeah,
you're also, by balancing on one foot, you're also strengthening the stabilizing muscles here.
Okay.
So it's so easy, and you just want to do that on both sides.
And what else do you have for us? Just simple things you can do, because I know a lot of our viewers are wearing heels.
Yeah, these are easy things you can do just to help relieve the pain and also prevent the pain. So the next is ankle circles.
Okay.
So circle clockwise, yeah, and circle counterclockwise. That encourages circulation to your foot, because when you're wearing heels, because of the angle it puts you on, it restricts circulation. So you want to just stimulate that circulation with ankle.
Okay.
Circles, and because we're balancing on one foot, again, we're working our stabilizer muscles.
And the last one.
The next is a calf stretch. So you're just putting your heel on your ground and you're bending down into a stretch.
Yep.
Your calf muscles get shortened by wearing heels. So by doing this, you're helping to lengthen them and relieve some of that high heel related pain.